Hello everyone. When you first meet people, do you know how to read them? Their emotions and thoughts? There's an old saying, the eyes are the windows to the soul. Sound familiar? How do your eyes express how you feel? In this video, we'll be discussing 8 signs of reading eyes. Let's get it on. Before getting into the details, I first have to explain the importance of baselining. The first step to figuring out if someone is lying to you is to find their baseline. A baseline is how someone acts when they are under normal, non-threatening conditions. You easily can establish baselines by sitting down with a person you want to read better, your child, your spouse, your friend, and talking casually to them about neutral topics that they would have no reason to lie about, such as the weather or what they want to have for dinner. Take note of how they act, how they hold their body, how they sound. Once you have established someone's baseline, you can look for some of the typical gestures people make with their eyes. As we will be discussing, if you see one of these clues and it is different from their baseline behavior, you know it is a red flag and you have to dig a little deeper. Number 1. The pupils. The pupils are a part of our body language that we practically have no control over. Pupil dilates when we are interested in the person we are talking to or the object we are looking at. As an indicator, check a friend's pupil size. When you're talking to them about something interesting, then change the subject to something less interesting and watch their pupils contract. Number 2, eye contact. For making contact and communicating with a person, effective eye contact is essential to our everyday interaction with people and also to those who want to be effective communicators in the public arena. Number 3. Persistent eye contact. Constant eye contact is often considered to be an attempt at intimidation, causing the person who's the object of a person's gaze to feel overly studied and uncomfortable. Even between humans and non-humans, persistent eye contact is sometimes unadvisable. Overly persistent eye contact is also a sign of a person's over-awareness of the messages they are emitting. In the case of a person who is trying to deceive someone, they may distort their eye contact so that they are not avoiding it, a widely recognized indicator of lying. Number 4. Evasive eye contact. Why do we avoid looking at a person? It may be because we feel ashamed to be looking at them, if you are being dishonest of trying to deceive them. Eye contact as a socializing device can take a surprising amount of effort to maintain when this energy could be spent on calculating as opposed to perceptive tasks. Number 5. Crime. In most cultures around the world, crime is considered to be caused by an extreme experience of emotion. Usually, it's associated with sadness or grief. Though often extreme experiences of happiness and through humor can cause us to cry. Often forced crying in order to gain sympathy or deceive others is known as crocodile tears, an expression from myths of crocodiles crying when catching prey. Number 6. Blinking. Aside from our instinctive need to blink, our emotions and feelings towards the person we are talking to can cause us to subconsciously alter our blink rate. Blinking more than average 6 to 10 times per minute can be a good indicator that a person is attracted to the person they are talking to, and is for this reason used as a sign of flirting. Number 7. Winging. In the West, people consider winging to be a cheeky form of flirting, something people do with others that we know or are on good terms with. However, there are cross-cultural variations on the issue of winging. Some Asian cultures frown up on the use of this form of facial expression. And finally, number 8, eye direction. What is the direction that someone looking in tells us about what they're thinking or feeling? Well, probably just what they are looking at. The thing to look out for is the direction someone's eyes are looking in when they are thinking. Looking to their left indicates that they are reminiscing or trying to remember something. On the other hand, looking to their right indicates more creative thoughts. And this is often interpreted as a potential sign that someone may be being deceitful in some situation, that is, creating a version of events. Note, if a person is left-handed, the direction indicators may be reversed. Also remember the following key points with regard to eye contact. Demonstrate that you are interested and active in interacting with someone by maintaining regular intervals of eye contact. But remember that constant eye contact can be intimidating. Pupil dilation can indicate someone is interested. It could alternatively be that the room has become brighter. Wink sparingly, even in cultures you know, accept such a gesture in jest. Avoid crocodile tears if you want to be considered trustworthy by your peers. So you guys ready to read eyes?